إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد قال الله جل وعلا بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على
منه الوقار يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداع إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون
الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran the month of Ramadan in which was revealed the Quran guidance for mankind clarification of the guidance and the furqan and the distinction between truth and falsehood. Whoever from amongst you is present at the time that the month of Ramadan approaches, فَلْيَسُمْ is a commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fast. And whoever is sick or on a journey, then let him make those days up مِنْ أَيَّامِ الْأُخْرَى from other days outside of Ramadan. Allah only wills for you ease and does not will for you difficulty. And so that you complete the term that has been allotted for you. And that you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of the Eid when they tukabbiru Allah ala ma hadakum. That you praise Allah and you glorify Allah at the end of this term for what He has guided you towards. And that you complete the term that has been allotted for you and that you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has guided you towards so that perhaps you may be grateful. Then Allah ends the verse with another section by saying that when my servants ask you, O Muhammad, about me, tell them that I am indeed near. I respond to everyone that calls on me. But let them respond to me and let them believe in me. So that perhaps they may be rightfully guided. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Lord of everything that exists. Another opportunity has presented itself for us to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and earn His pleasure. And those of us who are present today should be immensely grateful of the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed you to see another Ramadan. And to whom much has been given, much is required. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demonstrated this concept in theory and in practice. As he used to stand up at night and pray so long that his feet would bleed. And Aisha asked him, Ya Rasulullah, why is it that you stand like this? وَقَدْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكُ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven you for your past sins, your present sins, your future sins, Allah has forgiven you for that. You don't need to exert yourself like this. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded with the statement of a man who understands that to whom much is given, much is required. He said, Ya Aisha, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدٌ شُكُورًا Should I not be a grateful servant? Meaning because Allah has done that for me, should I not do more? Not less. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ And your Lord has proclaimed that if you show gratitude to me, I will give you more. I will give you more if you show gratefulness to me. And that's not just by word. But gratitude has pillars. Gratitude has elements that many of us have not acknowledged. That is the gratitude of the tongue. أَمَّا بِرَبِّكَ فَحَيْدِكَ That is the gratitude of the heart. وَمَا بِكُمْ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ There is no blessing that you have except that it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you acknowledge that, you realize how insignificant you are. And how much you don't deserve the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you.
there's the gratitude of the body, by exerting yourself, by doing more to prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are grateful. And as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned before he fought one of the battles, he said, "Wallahi lawla Allah ma jadayna wa la tasaddaqna wa la sallayna fa anzil as-sakinata alayna wa thabbit aqdamana in laqina." He said, "I swear by Allah, lawla Allah, if it wasn't for Allah, ma jadayna, we would have never found guidance. Wa la tasaddaqna wa la sallayna, and we would have never given sadaqah, nor would we have ever have prayed, nor would we have ever fasted, nor would we have ever done anything. It is all by the hidayah, the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." And then he continued by saying, فَأَنزِلِ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْنَا, so send down upon us tranquility, وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا, and make our feet firm, in لَقَيْنَا, when we meet our army, when we meet our enemies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His grace and mercy, has provided us with another opportunity to earn His pleasure, earn His forgiveness, earn all of the elements that the month of Ramadan comes and bears. There's a narration that is usually mentioned during this time that is munkar, that is not even, the weakness in the hadith is so shadeed, it is so severe. And many of the scholars have criticized many people who use it. Nonetheless, scholars have come behind and have explained that the hadith, the ma'na, the meaning of the hadith itself has a wajh, it has a perspective in the religion. And that is the statement that it was mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ramadan shahrun awwaluhu rahma wa awsatuhu maghfirah wa akhiruhu itqun min an-nar." That Ramadan is a month that the first part of it is mercy, the middle part of it is forgiveness, and the latter part of it is freedom from the hellfire. And although the narration is weak, there are many scholars past and present who have explained the ma'na, the meaning of the hadith. From amongst them, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala. Ibn Qayyim, he said, "Qawluhu awwaluhu rahmah, yani waqtu rahmah, rahmah nazila min indi Allahi jala wa'ala amatin, walau la husool rahmatihi ma saamala wa la qama ahadun min khalqi." He said the meaning of the Prophet's statement, or what is perceived to be the Prophet's statement, that the first part of it is mercy, meaning at the beginning of Ramadan, this is when the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends ammatin upon all of His creation. And if it wasn't for the attainment and the achievement of Allah's mercy, then no one would fast, no one would stand in prayer, no one would do anything. Why else would we be fasting? Why else would we be making this sacrifice except to earn Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy? He said, وَقَوْلُهُ أَوْسَطُهُ مَغْبِرًا, and that the statement that the middle of it is forgiveness, المعنى زمان المغفرة مترتبة على رحمة فإن الأجير قد يتعجل بعض أجره قرب فراغه منه. He said that the middle part of it being forgiveness, he said this is the time that we seek to earn the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, because perhaps the employee could sometimes request or hasten some of his reward, some of his compensation, as he is about to finish up his deed, as he is about to finish up his work. So he could request some of what he is working for. And that is the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah says in the Quran, وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that indeed you all will be repaid, you will be paid in full your reward on the day of judgment. And whomsoever has been removed from the hellfire and allowed to enter into Jannah, faqad faz, then he has indeed achieved the ultimate success.
وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. And the life of this world is nothing but a temporary enjoyment.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah in the Quran,
فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهَا مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
And no soul knows what is kept hidden for it as a reward, as a compensation for what it used to do, as a reward for what it used to do. So we know that there is a huge reward waiting in the hereafter, and we seek some of it as we are fasting during this month. Ramadan is a month, as the scholars say, is a madrasa, is a university. Ramadan is a university in which we learn many lessons. Lessons that we take along with us even after the month of Ramadan is over. Hadiyatun lana, as a gift for us. The month comes and it leaves, and we sacrifice, we exert ourselves, and then we gain a lot of lessons that we take along with us for the duration of our journey. One of the things that we learn in the month of Ramadan is sabr, patience. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and in the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an rabbihi qala, kullu hasanat ibn adam tudha'af ashratan ashran ila sab'ati mi'adif illa sawm fa'innuhu li wa ana ajzihi. يَدْعَى عَبْدِي شَهْوَتَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي يَدْعَى شَهْوَتَهُ وَشَرَابُهُ وَطَعَامَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي وَلِلْعَبْدِ الصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ فَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ فِطْرِهِ وَفَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in this hadith al-Qudsi that all of the actions of the children of Adam are multiplied between 10 and 700 times. Every good deed that you do is multiplied between 10 to 700 times. He said, with the exception of fasting. Fasting is for me, and I will reward my servant for fasting. My servant leaves off his desires, leaves off his food and his drink for me. And for the fasting servant, there's two times when he experiences happiness in his life, at the time when he breaks his fast, and at the time that he meets his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala to receive his reward for his fast. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, As-sabr, habsun nafs an ijabatu da'i al-hawa, wa kana hada haqiqatu sawm. Ibn Qayyim said, As-sabr, patience, is habsun nafs, is self-restraint, to restrain yourself from the caller to your desires. Da'in lil-hawa, to restrain yourself, to contain yourself from responding to the thing that calls you to follow your desires. And this is the reality of fasting. So much so that the one who does not learn self-restraint, then he runs the risk, or she runs the risk, of infringing on the reward for their fasting. And this is because obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires sabr. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man lam yad' bi qawli az-zuhr wal 'amal bihi, falaysa lillahi haja bi an yad'a ta'amahu wa sharabahu." That he who does not leave off giving false testimony, lying, and acting upon it, then I am not in need of him leaving off his food and his drink, because that means that you failed, you missed the objective. If you still want to sin in Ramadan, then you might as well eat and drink, because you get nothing from your fast except thirst and hunger, because you've missed the goal. The goal of fasting is taqwa. The whole purpose of fasting is God consciousness. So if you are still sinning while you're fasting, then you are self-defeating your purpose.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِن قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O you who believe,
fasting has been prescribed for you as it was prescribed for the nations that came before you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So that perhaps you may develop taqwa. You may develop God consciousness on a level that will prevent you from disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will develop God consciousness on a level where you would feel too embarrassed to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As one of the young men came to one of the scholars of the past, and he said, "Inna nafsi tad'uni ila ma'siyati Allah fa'idni." He said, "My soul, my desire continuously calls me to disobey Allah. Give me some advice." So he said to him, "The next time your desire calls you to disobey Allah, then obey me. Except in 5 instances." He said, "فَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَعْصِي اللَّهَ فَلَا تَسْكُنْ عَلَىٰ أَرْضِهِ" He said, "If you want to disobey Allah, then don't live on His earth." He said, "Subhanallah, أَيْنَ أَسْكُنْ وَأَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَأَسْيَعُ" Where am I going to live? All of the earth belongs to Allah. He said, "أَلَا تَسْتَحْيِي أَن تَعْصِي اللَّهَ وَتَسْكُنْ فِي أَرْضِهِ" He said, "Don't you feel the least bit of embarrassed that you disobey Allah and you live on His earth?" He said, "ثانياً إذا أردت أن تعصي الله فلا تأكل من رزقه." If you want to disobey Allah, the next time your soul calls you to disobey Allah, then don't eat from His food. He said, "How? كيف ذاك؟ ورزقي من عند الله. How is that when all of my provision come from Allah?" He said, "أَلَا تَسْتَحْيِي أَن تَعْصِي اللَّهَ ثُمَّ تَأْكُلْ مِنْ رِزْقِهِ" Don't you feel the least bit of embarrassed that the one who feeds you, you turn around and disobey? He said, "Give me the third." He said, "The next time that you decide to disobey Allah and the angels come to take you to the hellfire, tell the angels that you didn't do it. Tell the angels that it wasn't you." He said, "How?" When the angels, they record everything. إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى مُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدٌ مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ The angel on your right and on your left, not a word do you utter except that they write it down. This is the level of God consciousness that Ramadan will give to you if you open yourself up and trust the process. Many of us don't trust Allah's process. We trust our own process. I'm going to do it my way. And if you choose to do it your way, then you miss the point of being a Muslim. Because a Muslim is one who submits himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not your way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your way. Ramadan is the month of sabr. As the scholars say, a sabr aqsam thalath. There are 3 types of patience. As-sabr ala ta'atillah, being patient and being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one said being obedient to Allah was going to be easy. There's some mashaqqah, there's some difficulty in being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that requires patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا Order, enjoin upon your family prayer, وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا And be patient with that. Because it requires patience. الصَّبْرَ عَلَى طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ Being patient and being obedient to Allah. وَالثَّانِيًا الصَّبْرَ عَنْ مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ Patience and staying away from being disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ It takes sabr to stay away from being disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That requires patience. That requires self-exertion. And number 3, الصبر على قدر الله. And to be patient with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's some things that we can't change. And we say, سمعنا وطعنا. We hear and we obey and we understand that this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed for us. Number 2, Ramadan is a month where we earn the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قد جاء في سنن النسائي عن سلمة ابن أبي عبد الرحمن قال إن قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله فرض صيام رمضان وسننت لكم قيامه فمن صامه وقامه إيمانا واحتسابا خرج من ذنوبه كيوم ولدته أمه وإسناده الصحيح.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that indeed Allah has obligated upon you fasting in the month of Ramadan. وَاسْتَنَنْتُ لَكُمْ قِيَامَهُ, and I have demonstrated to you how standing in the month of Ramadan should be done. This is our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, left no stone unturned, demonstrating every act of worship that we have in our religion. Allah obligated upon you fasting in the month of Ramadan, وَسَنَنْتُ لَكُمْ قِيَامَهُ, and I have demonstrated to you how that should be done. He said, so whoever fasts in the month of Ramadan and stands in the month of Ramadan, إِمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا, believing that it is an obligation, desiring your reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, خَرَجَ مِنْ ذُنُوبِهِ كَيَوْمِ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ, he will come out of his sins like the day his mother gave birth to him. Allahu Akbar. Who from amongst us can afford to let this opportunity pass them by? To further emphasize the deprivation of the one who goes through the whole entire month of Ramadan with all of the virtues and the gifts that this month bears and still does not earn the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this person is extremely deprived and there is no good in him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, رَغِمَ أَنْفَ أَمْرِئٍ دَخَلَ عَلَيْهِ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ ثُمَّ خَرَجَ وَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ قُلْ آمِينَ فَقُلْتُ آمِينَ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was walking up the minbar and he said, Ameen, 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 three times. And so the Sahaba asked him, why did you say Ameen? He said, because as I was walking up the minbar, Jibreel came to me. And he said that whosoever from amongst the three things, he said, that whoever from amongst you enters into the month of Ramadan, and then he exits and still did not earn the forgiveness of Allah, then there's no good in him. Kun Ameen, say Ameen, O Messenger of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ameen. Now one could think, how is it that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could say Ameen to this? Because in the month of Ramadan, the gates of paradise are open. Outside of Ramadan, the gates of Jannah are only open Monday and Thursday. Monday and Thursday, which are the days that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved to fast. He said, because I like to fast, I like my deeds to go up to Allah while I'm fasting. That's Monday and Thursday. Outside of the month of Ramadan, in the month of Ramadan, the gates of Jannah are open every day. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَانِ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ وَسُلْسِلَةِ الشَّيَاطِينِ يعني مَرَدَّةِ الشَّيَاطِينِ أَشَدُّهُمْ عَلَى إِبْنِ آدَمْ وَلَيْسَ الْمَعْنَى كُلَّ الشَّيَاطِينِ. He said, when the month of Ramadan enters, the gates of Jannah are open and the gates of the hellfire are closed. And those shayateen that have severe hatred and hostility towards the children of Adam, they are chained up. And it does not mean that all of the shayateen are chained up. So if a person is not going to take advantage of this opportunity during the month of Ramadan, when are they going to take advantage of it? What other month do we have that has incentives like this? And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us not to forfeit this opportunity. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعَنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِمَا جَاءَ فِيهِ مِنَ الْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ. أقول ما تسمعون, أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين من كل ذنب, فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على دين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سراجا منيرا. أما بعد, the month of Ramadan is a month that we learn the act of giving
of being more generous
with everything, with compliments, with smiling, with money, with time, being generous with everything that we can possibly be generous with. As it was mentioned about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل في كل ليلة من رمضان فيدارسه القرآن فلا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من ريح المرسلة. But Aisha رضي الله عنها, she mentioned that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was the most generous of people. He never denied people anything. And this comes from someone who is content with life, and it comes from someone who is secure within himself. A person who is insecure feels very uncomfortable giving other people things that they believe gives them validation. Whether it's time, whether it's money, some people feel validated by their money. And if you feel validated by your money, you're not going to give it away, because that's an insecurity, that's a weakness, that's a vulnerability. Some people are narcissistic, they're insecure in terms of how they see themselves. So they self-praise. So to give someone else praise would be considered a vulnerability of theirs. So you'll find them never praising other people, never have anything nice to say about anyone else, but always welcoming the praise of themselves. This is an insecurity. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had an ajwad al-nas. He was the most generous of people because he was the most self-secure of people. He didn't have to deny people anything because he didn't seek validation from people. He didn't seek validation from material things. His validation came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said when he signed the peace treaty of Hudaybiyah, when they refused to acknowledge him as the messenger of Allah, he said, "Oh Allah, you know I'm your messenger. Wa in kadhabuni," even if they belie me, even if they deny me, meaning even if they refuse to validate me, you know that I am your messenger. Validation comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from other human beings. Aisha said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most generous of people, and the peak of his generosity was in the month of Ramadan, when Jibreel would meet him and study the Quran with him. It shows you that the person whose heart is open to the Quran, this person should be merciful, compassionate, generous, not hard-hearted, chase people away. This is not an indication that the Quran has penetrated your heart. This is not an indication that the Quran has penetrated your heart. He said that he was the most, she said that he was the most generous in the month of Ramadan, when Jibreel would come and study the Quran with him every night in the month of Ramadan. She said, La Rasulullahi ajwadu bil khayr min rih al mursala. She said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was as light as a breeze. That's how gentle he was with people. Everyone loved him. Everyone loved his character. Everyone loved to be around him. His character was like a breeze, a light breeze. And we pray that we are able to learn all of the gifts and benefit from the gifts that the month of Ramadan brings us. Very lastly, the month of Ramadan is a month of mercy. And just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends another opportunity to us out of His mercy, then we should extend opportunities to other people who have wronged us and give them an opportunity to right the wrongs that they've made against us. How can we request from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be merciful to us, and yet we refuse to have mercy on others? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Ar-rahimuna yirhamuhum ar-Rahman, irham man fil ardi yarhamukum man fis samaa." Ar-rahimuna, those who are merciful, yarhamuhum ar-Rahman, the most merciful will have mercy upon them. Irham man fil ard, be merciful to those who are on the earth. Yarhamukum man fis samaa, and the one that is above the heavens will have mercy on you. How can we turn and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His mercy, yet we forget, we refuse to have mercy on our children. We refuse to have mercy on our spouse. We refuse to have mercy on people who wronged us. Forgiveness is about you, not about the other person. When you forgive the person, you let it go, you are now freed from the bondage and the captivity of someone else holding you hostage. Let it go. Go into the month of Ramadan. La alayk, nothing upon you, wa la lak, and nothing against you. Nothing against you. You don't owe anybody anything, and no one owes you anything.
These were the words that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu said on his deathbed. He said, I wish that I could leave this world la alayya wa la li wa la alayya. Nothing upon me, I don't owe anybody anything, and no one owes me anything. That's how I want to depart from this world. I don't owe anybody anything, and I don't want anybody to owe me anything. Rectify what is between you and other people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rectify what is between you and Allah will rectify what is between you and other people. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ اللهم إنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكنن من الخاسرين يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عملا يقربنا إلى حبك اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك الكريم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.